Thanks, Mr. Louis, for speaking to Aurobindo Reseller. We would like to start off with an introduction about Pagero and what it does in this market.
Very good. Thank you very much. Pagero is a global, open, and smart network. We basically allow companies to connect to the network in order to exchange electronic documents for both the procure-to-pay and order-to-cash processes. So we basically assist companies to do more business.
So tell us more about your presence in this market. Which markets are you currently focusing on?
Yeah, obviously Pagero focuses on markets that has regulatory requirements that make sometimes for the companies difficult to be compliant. No? So in that sense, the Middle East, with the introduction of the VAT and most probably the upcoming introduction of real-time reporting of the produce invoiced. Other markets like India, no, where there is an introduction of the GST a couple of years ago, and now the government wants to have more control and clearance of that business. You have other markets like Australia, New Zealand, Singapore, all of them are following the trend of the European markets, but we're the pioneers on that, of the introduction of electronic invoices and controls on the indirect tax. No? So those are the areas where we focus when there is a regulatory requirement. Myself, sitting in this office in Dubai, we take care of the Middle East and Africa. Okay.
In terms of introduction of VAT, it has been fairly recent in this market, at least. Yeah. It's been only less than a couple of years since it was introduced. Yeah. When you speak to businesses, do they understand how do they need to adopt to, you know, the VAT pricing models, and how do they need to go and, you know, get themselves registered or maybe file for VAT? Yeah. What is the challenge over here?
Yeah, I think there's a few challenges. No, for bigger companies that are used to multinational environments, they are used to different tax regimes in different countries. They have their own tax departments. No, and they can manage that. No, in a much better way. But we have a lot of middle and small sized businesses here that have never used VAT before. So for those businesses, there is two major challenges. One of them is from the processes and systems internally. They are not able to cope sometimes with the requirement from the VAT perspective. The second challenge is the reporting, as you mentioned. No? Today we are in an environment in the Middle East where they are reporting normally on quarterly basis, but it looks that the introduction of some more stringent clearance models are going to bring that to almost real-time reporting, and that is going to be a very, very, very strong challenge for the SMEs, no, in this market. Yeah.
In terms of value add, there are a lot of other solutions also available in this market, which is similar to what you are offering. What would be your USP? What would be your unique selling point?
Yeah, I think it's a number of elements that differentiate Pagero from other similar products in the market. The first one is the openness of the network. No? So you have one connection with Pagero, but then you have access to everyone that is connected to the network, or everyone that is connected to any other network with interconnection relationship with us. No? So that's the first thing. It's not a closed-based network. It's a many-to-many type of connectivity. The second important element is compliance. We ensure compliance. We don't just make you be compliant today, but to stay compliant. So basically, you can offload that load, no, that you have internally into Pagero. We have an internal compliance department. We work with partners like Deloitte or like Thomson Reuters to make sure that you will be always compliant. And I believe that is a major differentiator, no, because we worry about you, okay, and that everything will be under the regulations of the market, no. So those probably are the two major ones. I would add a third one, which is around the real-time actionable data. No? We see today, no, that because we have a lot of paper invoices, no, that the market is just relying on header information from those invoices, which is not really valuable information at all. The introduction of electronic invoicing is bringing a much more actual, real, accurate data that can be then analyzed and actioned internally. No? So I think that's the third major differentiator as well.
Okay. In terms of go-to-market strategies, when you work with SMBs or when you work with your clients, do you work with them directly or do you go through a channel engagement?
Well, I mean, there's different ways. No, I think we go quite direct from the enterprise perspective. Our partners are as well the ERP providers or workflow providers, because we complement, we add value into the offering of the ERP and the workflow providers. For the SMEs, many of them are relying their accounting into some other offices or businesses that basically provide that service on their behalf. No, so we can go through to market through those ones as well. No, so very direct on the enterprise level. Indirect through the different type of partners that really we can have for the rest of the market. Yeah, as you know, every business has to do invoice. So for us, there are no specific verticals. Okay, so we can offer our services to any vertical, but obviously verticals that has more stringent regulations, like the health sector, like the retailing, and so on, are more prone to get into this type of services. No.
Okay. For 2019, half of the year is already gone, and we have only a couple of more years for the year to end. What kind of milestones do you want to achieve by the end of this year? What are your main focus areas that you would like to address?
Very good. Well, I think that there is a never changing regulation right now, okay, in the market. We can see that the Saudi Arabia, Jordan, other countries in the GCC, whether they are in the introduction of the VAT or they are on the next step, that is ensuring that there is a smaller VAT gap, no, in terms of making sure that they can collect all the VAT that is generated. No, so in that sense, our target for the year really is, first of all, to educate the market about the introduction of electronic invoicing. That's for us is a major challenge. Only 10% of the invoices globally are issued electronically. The rest is still paper-based. Okay, so only to do that education portion is very important for us. And the second main target is really to discuss with the different tax authorities and with the different regulators to make sure that they create a framework where companies like us can offer our services in an environment that will really create value for the businesses in the region. No? So that's where we are now.
Okay. Thanks for speaking to Arabian Resale. It was nice having you with us.
Thanks, Chris. Thank you very much. Yeah.